International Military Antiques is the largest military collectibles and antiques business in the world.
My name is Christian Cranmer, and I started this company, International Military Antiques, in New Jersey in 1981.
And we sell anything that would have been issued to a soldier. So that could be a World War II Jeep, it could be a flintlock pistol from 1620, or it could be a helmet that somebody wore in World War I. Anything that a soldier wore, we'll sell it.
We bring this stuff back. Generally speaking, you don't know who had it, what. You know what it is, you know what year it was made or what model it is and so on.
My favorite part of being in this business is that everything we sell has a story.
But just occasionally you find markings and you find names in backpacks, for instance. But, you find names on pistols, officers' names.
When you live with it, when you walk around, you can touch it, you can pick it up, it triggers something in your mind that technology can't do.
And what they're buying, it isn't the gun because it works. It's the gun because where it was or could have been. It's its association with history that is so important. You know, if you really thought what it was used for, it should all be thrown in the sea. But there's a lot of people who want to keep history alive.
It could be everyday people who just happen to come across our website, or it could be really hardcore collectors.
Our customer are individuals.
You know, as much as you love them, they're investments. A lot of these things are incredibly rare.
It's more seeing if you can actually make the gun perform again after being in Greece for 100 years.
The thing that really sets us apart is the size and variety of our inventory. Edge weapons like swords, bayonets, knives, bronze cannons from 1763, helmets from every nation you can think of that was involved in a major conflict. Display deactivated machine guns that are water cooled from World War I, World War II. We supply a lot of major Hollywood films like Saving Private Ryan, Band of Brothers, Fury, and really everything in between.
This afternoon we're gonna shoot the Victorian Rifleman Provincial Shoot.
Once a year we host an event for the Victorian riflemen.
Enthusiasts who shoot guns from the reign of Queen Victoria.
That includes the Brown Bess musket, the 1853 Enfield, the Snider rifle, and the Martini Henry, and everything in between.
Queen Victoria, she saw the biggest steps forward in history.
These guys come from all over the world. They meet here, they go through our warehouse, they're like kids in a candy shop trying to find something they haven't seen before. And then we have a big pig roast, we all have lunch, and we go out to the range. And it's really an amazing feeling to shoot something that's 200, 250 years old. You see the smiles on these guys' faces, it's like nothing else in the world they'd rather be doing.
Hey, who's next up here, gentlemen?
You start going through this stuff and you find real treasures.
Muskets that date back to 1776, from the time that America was at war for its own independence. When you think about that, that we have thousands of muskets that predate the beginning of the United States, it blows your mind. But that's what we sell. Sure, we can sell you an antique musket. We could sell you a World War II helmet. But what we're really selling is the story.